So in this class, we are going to write a program to fulfill or to solve this particular given problem. Now, let's read through the problem here. I will give you 2 minutes of time. I hope the screen is visible to you. Okay, and read the program statement and understand it. Okay, have you understood the problem here?
Yes, sir.
Okay, what we need to do here? What are the things? Okay, let me ask in this way. What are the inputs?
Sir, marks of 4 subjects.
Very good. What is the output?
We need to give as per average distinction. We need to classify.
Okay, only we average. Okay, is that
only total marks also?
Total marks also, right?
Total marks.
Yeah. Input is 4 subject marks. It will do the processing part, and once the processing is completed, okay, then we need to display the results. So in the result part, in the display part, first we need to print total. Second, we need to print average. Okay, and then we need to print result as well. But the result has to be calculated as per the given rules here. If the average is greater than or equal to 70, okay, greater than or equal to 70, then distinction should be shown as result. Or else, if the average is lying between anywhere from the 60 and less than 70, understand here, 60 and less than 70, then it should be a first class. In the same way, if the average is 50, okay, or less than 60, then second class. In the same way, if it is 40 or between or below the 50, then it is a first class. And very importantly, we need to understand the last point here. If any one subject is failed in the sense, if any one subject, okay, the score is less than 40, then it should be populated as fail. Now, for an example, okay, assume, for an example, let me give you some examples. Say, if these are the marks obtained, okay, say, now, total anyway, it will calculate, average it will calculate, okay, as per the common sense here, what would you think result is? Among these 5, what will be the result here?
Distinction.
Very good. Now, how about here?
First class.
Sir, distinction.
It is again distinction. Sir. It is distinction. Look at here, all 70. If you make an average also, average will come again 70 only. And for distinction, average should be equals to or greater than 70. It is equals to 70. So obviously it will be what? Distinction. See, this is what you, I have explained you, right? Understanding the problem, right? So this is how we need to understand our problem very well. Now, suppose if this is the case, tell me what will be the result here?
First class.
Definitely the average is going to be what? Just less than 70. So it should be a first class. Now, what about this?
Pass class.
Very good. Pass class. Okay. Now, how about here?
Fail.
Very good. Now?
Fail.
Think again. Are you sure with fail or do you think something else also?
Sir, fail.
No, because in one subject, the marks is less than 14. So.
Yes, very good. So this is the understanding of our program is correct here. Okay, now look at here. Subject marks are 100. Only one marks is less than 40. That means the even though average is more than 40, obviously, but the result will be fail because one of the subject the student has scored less than 40 marks. So this way we need to design our program here. Okay. So the understanding of the problem is perfect here. Let us go ahead and try to write the program for the same thing. Okay. Now, first statement, hash include stdio.h. Okay. Now, this program, I will make use of int main as I explained earlier in the previous class. Okay. Int main. Whenever we are writing an int main, make a habit of writing statements like this. Write an int main and at the last line, just write return 0 and keep your program ready like this. Whenever we are writing an int main, open bracket and closing flat bracket, and just before the closing bracket, write return 0 and keep it ready. That means our program is perfect with respect to the syntax of the int main, and we can write fill in our code on the top section. Okay, now. How many variables we require and what type of data type we have to use here?
Sir, int for all the marks.
Int for the all the mark subjects like M1
and
2
and total
and M4. Okay.
M total.
What about total?
Sir, int only.
Int only. Total is again int only. Right? Then what about average?
So it will be in float.
Float. Very good. So we have average in the float, right? So variable declaration is done. Do you think any other variables we require here? I think no, right? Only these variables are sufficient here. Okay. Next is what we need to input the data, right? So we have to ask user to enter 4 subject marks. So printf.
Printf.
4 subjects marks. Okay. Then double quote complete, close the brackets and semicolon. Scan F. How many we need to read? 4. So 4 percentage DV I will use. 2, 3, 4. 2, 3, 4. Then comma, ampersand M1. Ampersand M2, ampersand M3, and the last one, ampersand M4. Correct? Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, so input part is done now. Next, what we need to perform? As program statement says,
we have to find total now.
Marks. Yes, read the 4 subject marks, then calculate and print total, average and result. So let us go in the same sequence. First, let us calculate total and average and we'll print the total and average. Then we will calculate the result as per these rules and then display that as well. Okay. Now let us calculate the total here. Okay. How can I construct the statement for total?
Total is equal to M1 plus M2 plus M3 plus M4.
Yes, very easy, right? Total is equals to M1 plus M2 plus M3 plus M4. Okay, right. Next, we will calculate average as well. So average will be statement. We can
write AVG.
AVG equals to
total. Total divided by.
Total divided by 4.
4. Okay. Now, does anybody think
the 4.0?
Yes, you have to be smart here, right? Whether should I use only total divided by 4 or something else. Why something else? Because average is what? A floating point number.
Float
value. Total is integer and the 4 is also an integer. And you know that when we divide integer by integer, the result will be in integer only. But here we might be interested in what? Interested in the fractional part also. So we need to typecast it. Since one number is a constant here, let me make it be a 4.0. This way also I can do, or other way is I can make it to be a float here. This way also I can do. The simplest form will be what? Making the 4 to be 4.0. Clear?
Sir, we need to print now. To print F. Yes.
Let us print the total as well as average. So print total marks equals to percentage D, okay, slash N, double quote complete, then total. Okay. Now, similarly, who can tell me the statement for average?
Print F.
Wait, let me ask random students. Okay. Narendra, roll number 227. Narendra, unmute yourself. Narendra, are you there? Are you mentally present? No, not present. Nidhi, roll number 229.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Nidhi. Good. Nidhi, will you tell me the statement which will print the average?
So scanf.
Scanf. What we need to do, Nidhi, here is that understanding. Did you understood first? What are we going to, what I told you to tell the statement for, we need to display the average marks which we have calculated in this statement.
No, sir, not getting.
Bhagyashri. Bhagyashri, turn off your video and turn on your audio. Bhagyashri, 206. Bhagyashri, speak now. Okay, let us do one thing here. When I call some student and ask them to respond, and if they don't do, then that particular day's attendance will be rejected, even though you put in their attendance. So far, a couple of students happen to be like that. If you don't respond to me, then you are not eligible for granting the attendance. Anish Vernekar, roll number 201.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, tell me the statement what I need to write here. I want to print the average.
Total is equal to AVG greater than or equal to.
Roll number 210, Divya.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, tell me the statement what I need to write. I want to print.
Sir, print F.
Print F.
Sir, open the bracket.
Okay.
Average marks. Sir, double quote.
Double
sir, code. Before average, sir, average marks.
Average marks.
Is equal to percentage F.
Percentage F.
slash n
slash n
sir double quote complete comma and average sir avg sans semicolon.
Very good. Yeah, you can unmute, you can mute yourself. Okay, fine. So we have calculated the total and average and also displayed the those two values. Okay, now next what we need to do, we need to calculate the result as per given rules. Now tell me, among these given rules, which is the rule you will check it first? Think first.
Fail.
Okay.
Fail.
Yes, sir. I think fail.
Fail. Okay.
No, sir. Distinction.
Distinction. Okay.
Sir, if we'll check the fail statement first, then in else part we can do nested if else.
Okay, so first
check, if we check for the fail first
and then go for the in a nested if else the other things. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Now I'm getting more answers towards the checking of the fail at the beginning. Why we need to do that part? Can anyone explain?
Because sir, to display the result.
To display the result.
To display the result. Yes, we obviously we need to display the result, but why is that only fail has to be considered at the first priority here?
Because others are bit similar, this is bit different.
Okay, shall we do one thing here? When I ask a question, students are more enthused to answer. There is an option to raise your hands. Do you find in your app? Okay. So you just raise your hands, then I will ask any one of you. Okay, Saurav, now you answer.
Sir, because the other condition are similar, but the fail condition is bit different. So we have to check it first, then we can do the we can check the other condition in the nested if else.
Okay. What about Parashram?
So in other condition we have to go for the average marks, whereas in fail condition we have to check for any of one if he is failing that subject only as a particular subject.
Okay, fine. What about Jay Prabhu?
Sir, in the first three conditions there is given two values, so we should calculate in between the two values. But for fail, if it is less than 40, we can consider it fail easily.
Okay.
So it will be easy to consider.
Omkar?
Sir, we need to conclude first fail, because if a student is failed, then we may not be proceeding further steps like calculating the distinctions of first class. If he's failed, then it's considered as fail. There is no further steps.
Okay. Fine. Any other answers? Anyone else? Good, good. So most of you, all of you have tried to put in the, okay, Nidhi?
Yes, sir. We should consider the fail itself, sir.
Why? And the question is why?
Because all other, it can be considered very easily, sir, as the condition says less than 40, sir.
Okay. Okay.
So all others are, sir, fail is... easy to consider, sir.
Siddharth? You want to speak, Siddharth?
Okay. Yes, sorry, I admitted, sir.
Okay, fine then. Fine. You can just lower your hands. Okay, next time when I ask question, then you can again raise it. Okay, now most of you have tried to put in the thoughts correctly. Now let us see why only the fail is. Let me put it in a proper frame here. Now look into these scenarios here. The test cases why I have provided here. Okay, these are kind of a test cases, you can say. Means when these values are there, what is the expected result? Look into all these things and you have to think about the last case. Average is obviously greater than 40 here. Average is greater than 40, okay? But one of the marks is failed marks. In such cases, the student has to be displayed as a fail itself. Suppose if we don't check fail at the beginning, then what may happen? If this is the case, in this case, what will happen? 100, 100, 100 plus 35, total how much? 335. So 335 divided by 4 means I think you will get a distinction marks, around distinction marks only you will get. If we are not checking for a fail and we are going in this order, like a first check for the distinction, then check for the first class, second class, past class, then definitely the average will get struck where? It will get caught in the first class itself, that is the distinction. And the result will be displayed as what? The distinction itself, even though the marks is failed marks. So in order to overcome this problem, first we need to handle the failure. Any one of the subject marks is less than 40, then we need to print a statement to be result as fail. If not means if none of the four subject marks are fail, means if all the subject marks are greater than or equals to 40, then we should handle these four in the same sequence. Same sequence means first check for the distinction, next go for first class, then go for second class. Okay, if all these three are not satisfied, then definitely it will be what? Past class. So in this way, we need to construct our coding here. Okay, then, so now we understood why we need to calculate fail first. Now tell me how we can construct or how we can write the statement corresponding to that, which will calculate or which will try to find out whether any of one of the subject is scored less than 40 marks. Raise your hands. What statement I need to write? Obviously, it will be what? A if. I need to write a if. Okay. And then suppose if this condition is true, I will write a statement to be what? Printf stating to be result is fail. Result is fail, I will mention. Okay, this will be executed. Else, I'm going to write for other statements later here. This will be my program, how it will look. If this condition is true, result will be fail. If this condition is false, then in the else block, I'm going to further write the other statements which will calculate the result to be a distinction, first class, second class, or a past class. Okay. Now tell me what condition I should write here in the line number 32. Raise your hands. If any one of the subject marks is less than 40. How many subjects are there? There are four subjects. So each of the subjects I have to check for. What I have to check? Whether that subject is less than 40 or not. First subject is less than 40 or not. Second subject is less than 40 or not. Okay. Yes, Saurabh, you can speak now.
So can we use a logical or?
Logical or. Okay. Now, students, we have studied some logical operators wherein we can look for multiple true or false values. Basically, logical operators works on the Boolean values, true or a false type of values. So even here, we are requiring the same thing here. Yes, Siddharth.
Sir, we can go for a logical AND operator as sir, because we can check M1 is smaller than 40, then mm-hmm. It will be true. Then it will go for next AND statement, sir. Logical AND.
Okay. Now I got logical operators as a result, as the answers from two of you. And one says logical OR and other says logical AND. Okay. Now, what do we think? Which one we should use? Should we use logical OR? Or
sir, if we use logical or sir, then the false statement, then only when the conditions are false, then it will give false. Then otherwise it will give true results, sir.
Okay. So logical or is what? Now we need to recollect our understanding of the logical or and logical AND. So first logical AND, how it works. If all the conditions are true, means all its operands are true, then the result is true.
True.
If anyone is false, then the result is false. Okay. What about the other one? Logical or if any one of the condition is or any one of the operand is true, then result is true. Okay. And if all the operands are false, then the result is false. Now, what we require here, if any one of the subject is less than 40, then result is fail. Isn't it? Understanding the thing here. Try to understand this statement. If any one of the marks is less than 40, means if it is true, then the result is fail. That means we should use logical or here, not the logical and, right? So we need to use logical or here. Then how can we construct that conditions here, that particular statement here? What we need to do, we need to check, is marks 1 less than 40? If marks 1 is less than 40, then what? Result definitely will be fail. Let us do in this way. Let us check for only one subject. Suppose if first subject M1 is less than 40, that means what? Result is fail. Correct? Now here, along with this one, we want to add one more subject, that is M2 also. Is that M2? Again, we will check whether M2 is less than 40. If that is also true, then the result should be what? Result should be fail. Okay. Then what about this M3? If M3 is also less than 40, then also result should be fail. And if M4 is also less than 40, if this also is less than 40, then the result should be fail. If any one of this condition, any one of this condition is true, then the result, what we are expecting is as result fail. So now we need to fill in the gap between these operators, whether it should be a and or it should be a or. That is what we are focusing here. If it is a and, then when all these conditions are true, then only result will be true. This result will be false. But we don't want that. What we want, if any one of the marks is less than 40, then the result is fail. So here, between these conditions, we have to use logical or statements. We have to use logical or statement. If M1 is less than 40, if that is true, then result is fail. Even though all these three subjects, suppose if those subjects are 100 also, but M1 is less than 40, result will become fail. In the same way, suppose if M3 is less than 40, but all other three are greater than 40, then also result becomes fail. Right? Is this understood, students?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine.
Sir, I have a doubt.
Yes, Nayanshri.
Sir, why can't we use logical and? Because in logical and, if all the statements are true, then only it shows true. But then we need the thing which is false.
Yeah. So let us make that one. We will make it to be a logical and. Okay. Let us try to do it. No worries. Okay. We will make logical and now. Now, when the entire condition becomes true, when the entire condition becomes true, then the result will be what? Fail. Or else, yeah, it will go into this particular block where it will handle the other four scenarios. Okay.
Yeah.
Assume that first subject marks is 100. Second subject marks is 100. Sorry. Second subject marks is also 100. Third is also 100. Fourth one is what? Say, okay, now try to analyze here. As per a theoretical concept, we expect result should be fail. Correct, Nayashri?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now let us try to understand here. We are using logical and here. First, we will work upon this condition. Let me write it here. Okay, let me write here. So first one, M1 less than 40. Is it true or false?
False.
False. Then, and M2 less than 40.
False.
Then, false. Then,
true.
True. Okay. Now, what will happen here?
Yeah, we are going to get. We are going to get the result as false itself.
We are going to get the result as false itself.
False.
That means what will happen? Print result as a fail, or will it go into this else block?
False.
See, this entire result will lead to what? Will lead to a false value, correct? Will lead to a false value. That means the condition, if this condition is now resulting into a false value.
Okay, then it will go to the next statement. Yeah, but we need it to be true. Okay.
But what we need, we want in this case also, it has to print to be a false value, a fail value.
So that's why
we make use of a OR. Suppose here it is a OR, how it works? What? Any one of the condition is true itself.
Yes.
One of the current is true. That means this will give us a true value.
Fail. Okay. Then it will give result in fail.
Understood?
Yes. Yeah, sir.
Okay. Let's change it. So this way, if you have doubts, you have to make a change and try to check it whether how the program will work with respect to a set of values. Okay, fine. Now we have handled this case. Now let us forget about this particular case. Okay. Now we will look into the other possible values when the result is not fail. Not fail means all the subject marks are greater than or equals to 40. Then we need to take care of these things. Okay. These cases. Now how can I check the average for the distinction? I can write a simple if statement, right? If average greater than or equals to 70. If average greater than or equals to 70, what has to be done? Printf
distinction
is distinction, isn't it? Correct?
Yes, sir.
Now, suppose if it is not, if the average is not greater than or equal to 70, then it may be anyone between these values. It may be 60 or 70 or 50 to 60 or 40 to 50. Now we need to again look in for the other values. So now let us go for the second case, that is for the first class. Now who can tell me the statement for the first class here? Who can I write? Yes, Saurabh.
Else if sir, bracket open. Average second is, can I just look the above it? Average, okay. Small average is lesser than 60. Greater than 60.
Greater than 60. Yes, greater than 60 or greater than or equals to also.
Greater than equal to 60.
Greater than or equals to 60.
And logical and?
Logical and?
And average smaller than equal to 70.
Average smaller than or equals to, not equals to here. It should be only less than. Because
Smaller than 70. Less than.
It will cover in the distinction part. So only less than 70.
That's 70.
Correct? So in this case, our printf statement will look like result is first class. Correct? Okay. Then, now who can answer for the other part? If it is not distinction also, if it is not first class also, someone else now, apart from those Siddharth, no Siddharth, anyone else? Yes, Parashram.
Else, sir, we can directly print the statement.
Else.
Because printf, result is equal to past class. Sorry, sir. Second class is there, then for second class, same as we used to, we can write as that same.
I can write it as a 60 only. Greater
level. No, sir.
Huh?
No.
You said same, no?
Sir. I want to check 50. For the values.
50 to 60.
Yeah. The 50. Logical AND symbol.
And average.
Then
average is greater 60. Than 70. 60 or 70?
60, sir. 60. Greater than 60, sir. Printf result second class.
Printf result is second class. Okay, perfect. Next. So we handled distinction part, we handled first class, we have handled also the second class.
Semicolon.
Very good. Next.
So we can directly go for the past class.
Past class. Right? We don't need to have again a condition here, right? So we have handled all the conditions. If the average doesn't fall under these categories, then definitely it is what? Class will be what? Just a past class. So just display that to be a result as past class.
Semicolon.
Fine. Shall we go ahead and program?
No, sir. For line number 33, there's a semicolon missing, sir. Printf.
Very good. Okay, students, meanwhile, enter your attendance. Be quick. Okay, enter your attendance. I'm just going to compile the program now. Let's go for the compilation. GCC. Program number is 17. Wow, very good. We didn't get any of the compilation errors here. That means you guys have told me the correct program, right? The mistakes which we had in semicolons and all. So you have corrected me before compilation. That is very good sign. Okay, let us go ahead and then let us run the program here. Enter 4 subject marks. Now, which scenario should we take first? Is that distinction? First class, second class, past class,
fail.
Let us go with the same values, 100, and then a fail marks, 35. And then enter. Look at the results here. Total, it displayed correctly, average correctly, and the result we are getting as expected as the fail, right? So that is our program is working correctly for this set of values. Let us rerun the program for checking the distinction part. So anyone can tell me the values for distinction part?
Hundred and seventy-eight.
Fine. Correct? We are getting distinction, that is as expected. Now, what about the first class?
Seventy, seventy, sixty-nine.
Yes. First class, perfect. Last one for the second class. So one more is there. Second class. Shall we do the same values? Similar values. 60, 60, 60, and 59. So we're just checking the border values. Second class. That is also correct. Let us check this value as well. One more value. 60, 60, 60, and 60. What is expected here?
First class.
First class, sir.
First class, right? Shall we check whether we get a first class here? Yes, first class. Last set of values for the past class. Yeah, one of you.
50, 50, 50, 49.
Past class. So is that understood, students?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So whenever a given problem is there, first thing is that we need to analyze the problem. We need to understand ourselves that, okay, that particular problem is very well understood. Then only go for writing or finding the solution for that. Right? I hope this type of a solution, if you try to approach or if you try to write any program, whenever given problem is given in this way, then definitely there will not be any mistakes, kind of a logical errors basically, right? So our program will be perfect here. Right? Shall we wind up for today's class? I hope each one of you have put in the attendance. Those who have entered the attendance, put in your attendance quickly. I will give 30 seconds.
Sir, I just wanted to ask one thing. We had studied that thing if we don't want 6 zeros after the decimal point. So what we were supposed to add there in the program?
Yes. Who can answer? Anyone?
Sir, I forgot that thing. So
yeah, let's recollect it.
Sir, in printf average marks statement, sir, we have to add percentage 0.2f.
Yes. So here we want to have that, we need to handle that part, right? So between this percentage symbol and f, we need to restrict it for only two decimal points. So 0.2, if I write 0.2, and then let's remove this one, and compile the program, and then just quickly run it. Say 50, 50, 50, and 68. 54.50. See, we just restricted it to only two decimal points. Correct?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Fine then. We will wind up for today's.